Hi everyone, I'm Brit. I'm a health coach and registered dietitian here at Parsley Health. And today I want to talk to you about something that you might have heard of and maybe even tried, and that's plant-based meats. Brands like Beyond and Impossible Burger are seemingly everywhere now. You can even find them at Dunkin' Donuts and Burger King. But the big question is, are these meat-free alternatives actually healthy for you? Today we're going to dive deep into the science and nutrition of these meatless meats today. So why do we care about an alternative to red meat in the first place? Debates have been going on for years about whether we should reduce or eliminate red meat. Some studies have even shown that eating red meats could lead to heart disease, cancer, or diabetes, while others have shown that cutting back on red meat has little to no impact on our health. There's really no clear answer. Recent analyses suggest we don't actually need to worry as much as we thought about any potential negative effects of eating red meat. At Parsley Health, we recognize everyone is different. Different genetics, microbiomes, and other health markers influence all how we should be eating for optimal well-being. Our recommendations are personalized, but overall, a wide variety of food is typically best for everybody. So let's talk about nutritional information. The plant-based meats and organic grass-fed meat aren't actually that different when looking at the nutrition information. So for example, Impossible Burger has 240 calories, 14 grams of fat, and 370 grams of sodium, and 19 grams of protein. The Beyond Burger is similar. It has 290 calories, 22 grams of fat, and 450 milligrams of sodium, and 20 grams of protein. And for red meat, actually ground beef, it typically has 243 calories, 17 grams of fat, 75 milligrams of sodium, and 21 grams of protein. While the beef burgers do have less sodium and carbs than plant-based meat alternatives, they're very similar by numbers, so it's actually best to compare the quality of ingredients at this point. So it really does come down to the ingredients. Organic grass-fed beef is actually one ingredient, it's beef. So let's talk about what organic and grass-fed actually mean. Organic means that the feed doesn't have any antibiotics, chemical fertilizers, or pesticides used, but this does not indicate the quality of the life the animal has had, which is actually really important to the overall quality of meat. And grass-fed means that basically that the grass is the cow's natural diet. They eat the bugs, the vegetation, and the grass in the pasture versus conventionally raised cows, which are typically fed corn and grain, which they definitely don't prefer. And then this influences the nutritional quality of the actual product. Plant-based meats often have a list of 20 plus ingredients on the other hand. Many of them are actually processed and questionable. For example, there's lots of refined oils like soy, canola, and corn. And unless it's cold pressed and virgin, it likely goes through a chemical process during manufacturing. And this can result in oxidation. And that's basically when the fat molecules interact with oxygen. And this usually is a result of applying heat. Studies show when vegetable oil is oxidized, it can actually create a toxic compound that leads to adverse effects of our health, like inflammation. These processed meats are more likely to spend a lot of time in the manufacturing process, which then increases the chances that the oil will oxidize. There are some other questionable ingredients as well, like for example, maltodextrin, which is a type of sugar, and soy. Refined soy can actually be problematic for women of reproductive age due to its estrogenic effects, and its difficulty to be digested in some people. We've talked a lot about the nutrition information and the quality of ingredients in plant-based meats versus organic grass-fed beef, but it also comes down to thinking about this comparison as a whole food versus a processed food. Even if they have similar nutritional info, plant-based meat is not created equal. There's this natural synergy among the vitamins and nutrients in meat that's almost impossible to replicate. It's more difficult to understand these interactions when you're trying to create a food that mimics a whole food. For example, protein from meat is more absorbable than from plants. Animal proteins contain more amino acids, and they're more bioavailable, meaning the body can absorb it more easily. This effect cannot be replicated in meat alternatives. We also want to note that there are other factors when deciding between eating plant-based or more meat, like ethical reasons and environmental, but today we just focus on the nutrition aspects. Ultimately, focusing on eating whole foods and always double-checking the quality of ingredients, not just the nutrition facts, is a good idea for everyone, no matter what diet you follow. If you want to give the new plant-based meats a try, try them, but know that they're really nutritionally similar to other high-quality beef patties, but may also contain a few questionable ingredients.